Cashman.
And I'm Shannon Cake. Thanks for staying with us here tonight. Two drivers got the scare of their lives after their vehicles became the targets of teen snipers. News Channel 5's John Shaman is live in the Treasure Coast newsroom tonight with that story. John?
Well, Shannon, in this story, we're not talking about real guns, but imagine you're just driving down the road and suddenly it sounds like you're under attack.
I was driving down the road, and next thing I know, I heard a big shatter.
Dan Borden shows where this window once was on his pickup truck.
Shot about right here, where the puncture was.
Last Tuesday night, he was driving along Crosstown Parkway at Cashmere Boulevard in Port St. Lucie when a pellet knocked out his side window. Only the tint kept the glass from spraying throughout the truck.
The police, Port St. Lucie, came out, took a report. While we were there doing my report, another couple had pulled up and said that they had been hit, too, in the door.
Crossing guard Patty Brown patrols the intersection, and news of the shooting put her on edge.
Kind of makes me scared now because here we are working out here, and we don't know if something like that could happen to us.
After a few days, Dan Borden figured he'd be out the $250 it cost for the new window, but police were keeping their eyes open.
On Monday, an officer was patrolling in the area when he noticed two teens around the retention pond, and both were carrying something suspicious.
It turned out the teens had a BB gun and a BB rifle with a scope. As police questioned them, they admitted to shooting at the two vehicles the previous week.
What was to say that, you know, somebody had the window open and someone got hit in the face, or if there was a child in the vehicle, or someone got scared and the window shattered and that car veered off and hit another vehicle?
I have a 11-year-old son, and he usually sits in that seat when we go and go places, and he stayed home that night, and I'm just glad that nobody got hurt or seriously injured.
The teens, 14 and 15-year-old cousins from Port St. Lucie, both face felony charges. Live in the Stewart Newsroom, John Shaneman, WPTV, News Channel 5.